James Aspey here at this giant cube of truth here in San Francisco. We have, I've been told, about 6 cubes with 500 people here today.
Whoa.
And it's just taking over. So James, tell us about speciesism for a minute.
Oh, that's a great start to an important conversation, man. Speciesism is the root of this entire issue. The issue I'm talking about is that humans believe that we are superior to every other species, and we've really taken it to the point that we think we're so much better than them. We discriminate against them so strongly that we believe it gives us a right to literally mutilate them, torture them, kill them, breed them into existence, steal their babies from their mothers, all because we like how they taste. So we're saying that, like, humans are saying that we're up here, they're down here. That gives us the opportunity to do whatever we want and own their lives and use them and commodify them. And that's speciesism, that superiority complex which humans have. Just like white people had it against black people, thinking that was superior so we could enslave them. Men believe they had it against women so we could own women and take away some of their rights, like the right to vote, things like that. Humans take away every single right that these individuals have, the right to freedom, the right to their own life. That's what speciesism is, man. It is a massive injustice. It happens all over the world. It's the most normalized injustice that I'm aware of, because nearly every single person on the planet is consuming the products of violence, torture, and killing. So imagine how good it will be when we wake up to our speciesism, which is exactly what happens when we go vegan. When you start realizing that you do not need to consume animals to be healthy, then therefore the only justification for doing so is because you enjoy how their bodies or their secretions taste, you realize, well, that violence against them is not something I would want done to me, and what is the difference between us and them? They feel pain and suffer, we feel pain and suffer. They don't want to die, we don't want to die. So we treat them the way that we'd want to be treated. That's how we get through this speciesism. And then if you really want to make a change, like, you can't just know that there's a problem, we have to fix the problem. To fix the problem is when we go vegan. That means we stop using these animals. Just like when you stop being racist, you stop using slaves, you know? When you realize, oh my God, I'm wrong about this, they are equal, we shouldn't do this, you make the necessary changes. That means you eat a plant-based diet, a vegan diet. You don't wear the skins or the fur of another species, of anybody. You don't use them for testing products on or anything like that.
Speaking up for them as well, we got to become active. Just as if we were the victims, we would want people to not just stop buying the products of the violence that's been committed against us, we would want people to speak out on our behalf, right?
Excellent point, my friend. Einstein has a great quote. He says, those who have the privilege to know have the duty to act. Step one, stop contributing to the violence. Step two, help others do the same. Help others wake up to their own speciesism. Help others see the path out of it, and help others walk peace and respect.
And you've got such a great energy, James, and I know you believe, man, in these people. These are good people.
Dude.
99% of these people are against animal cruelty, right?
Exactly,
we just got tricked into thinking that that slaughter somehow isn't animal cruelty, right?
Humane slaughter, man.
Yeah.
I mean, who's telling us that? The people who want us to buy their products.
Right.
They have tricked us, they have deceived us, they have told us that we need meat for protein, dairy for calcium, that fish don't even feel pain. We've been told a whole lot of lies, unfortunately, but the truth is out there, man, and we're spreading it. And I do believe in everybody, dude. I believe in them so much because I didn't care about animals at all, and I change. And I see hunters who go out there and shoot animals in the face and enjoy that. I see them go vegan and become vegan activists. I see people at slaughterhouse workers who usually stab animals in the throat, 100 of them a day, realize, you know what, I was wrong, I should never have done that job, and they go vegan too. So to find just a normal, typical person who doesn't really think about what they're buying when they're at the supermarket, man, I see them go vegan every single day, dozens and dozens of them. It is actually happening, man, because this is a rational argument in favor of a better world, and there's no argument against it. So anybody can do it, everybody should do it, people are doing it, millions of us all around the world. It's the fastest growing social justice movement of our time, and it's exponentially growing. But we need, for this issue, like, if you imagine how much suffering is happening because of speciesism, if you imagine how much violence, how many individuals are getting their throats slit, which is literally the leading cause of death on planet Earth, throat slitting. If you don't want to live in a world like that, then it's not enough just to, oh yeah, that sounds good on those vegans. No, you go vegan, you help others do the same.
Thanks. Thank you, my friend.
Yeah, my bro.
Oh, so good, bro. So good.
Four, so you're sure you're 100% a carnivore. Okay, next time that you go to the store, just grab some chicken or bacon and pork and open it up. Eat it raw with no seasoning or no sauce. No more knives and no more forks. And let's see who's hitting the floor, cause all carnivores have paws and claws. We have hands to pick fruit and veg off trees and plants, so please understand. If you put fruit and a rabbit in a baby's cot, it will play with the rabbit, then it'll eat the fruit. Do the same with a lion's cub, and what do you think that lion will do?